Hello. Today I'm going to go over how to use Excel's REPT or repeat function and how to use the lookup function in a unique way in order to return the last occurrence of a value inside of a ordered column rather than the first occurrence. So the lookup function is part of the lookup family that also has the VLOOKUP and the HLOOKUP and the lookup itself. The main difference between the lookup and the VLOOKUP is the VLOOKUP is order independent and it will return the first occurrence, whereas the lookup function, depending on if it can find a value or not, first off has to be in ascending order, and secondly can return the last value instead of the first value. So, and I'll show you what I mean in this example. So this file that I have right here is going to be an SAP bill of materials. So this bill of materials, or BOM, B-O-M, has a level inside of the tree structure that a component sits in and the component itself. Now, if you've ever seen a bill of materials or BOM, that is actually useful to have these indented so you know when the next level starts instead of having to look at this level to try to find where a part number changes. So the first thing that we want to do is create an indented part. So this is going to use the REPT function, and that will take the text and will repeat it a given number of times. I want to repeat the space text 4 times and add it before the part number so I can see it indented. Now, for the first level, I don't want it to be indented, so I'll subtract 1 from it. But then for the second level, it will give me 4 spaces in the part number. The third level will give me 8 spaces in the part number, and so on. Now, if I look at that, this now takes this level over here in a flat part, and it will give you the indented part number. Now, if you need to, if you copy and paste this over and you remove this original part and need to remove these spaces in the future, you can simply come back and use the trim function and it will remove all the spaces for you. So I like to think of the REPT as kind of a reverse trim in this scenario. Now what we want to do is find the parent of the part. So the parent of the part, if I look at these ones right here, now that it's going to be in a very nice order, I can see that all of these are the direct children of this 423-0404. So I want to put this 423-0404. I want to basically see it over here. Well, now in order to get that in an equation form, I'm just going to type out the equation and not really explain it that much right now. Once I have it in here, I'm going to go back with a PowerPoint and walk through each step of that equation. So first off, we have a lookup. The lookup value is going to be 2. The lookup vector we're going to create as an array expression. We want to take the current level, subtract 1 to find the parent level. And if we find the result, we want to return the parent. And if it's an error, we're going to want to give it a dash. Now we want to link these to the very top. And once they're linked to the very top, I'll come through here. And we can just copy and paste that. So if you remember, I said for these ones, I wanted to get the 423-0404. And that's exactly what we got here. Now, something to note that's not in the breakdown of the formula, but you can use it in a lot of different formulas, is I ended up having this array that we have here. I anchored the very first cell to the first occurrence in the column, but then I left this last one being relative. So as I go down one by one, you can see that the array keeps on growing based on the current row that I'm at, but it always starts at the very beginning of the data set. So as I keep on going down, it's always going to be locked to that D2, but it will grow with each row that I have. Now, if we actually look at the formula itself, first, based on Microsoft's description of the lookup function, there are two main features that we need to know about the lookup in order to understand this equation. The first one and most important is if the lookup cannot find the lookup value, and in our case that lookup value is 2, it will match the largest value in the lookup vector that is less than or equal to the lookup value or the number 2. Now the second thing that's important is Excel assumes that the lookup vector is in ascending order, and even if it's not in ascending order, Excel thinks that it is, and it will return the wrong value if you use lookup in a different future function and you don't have the lookup vector in the proper order. Now, the sample array that we're going to be dealing with is just going to be the first 10 elements that we have in our file. Now, what I want to do is look up this first part that's going to be a level 5, and I want to return the parent, which is going to be this 169 dash. Now, breaking down this formula, we begin by looking at this middle part right here in red. Now, this middle part basically creates an array of true and false going from the very first row, this D2, to the current row that you're at, D8. Now, this D8, as I mentioned, will grow to D9 or D10 if you're at the 9th or the 10th row in Excel. Now, I want to take this array that we have. I want to see if it equals the current row that we're at, the current component, subtract 1 from the level, so the parent's level, the current component, I want to return a true or false array going from the current row that we're at all the way up to the very beginning. So in Excel, it will return true if the row in column D equals 4, and it will return false if it does not equal 4. Now in Excel, treats true as the number 1 and false as the number 0. So in our array buildup, it will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Now, what we want to do is use a little trick of the lookup function and array formulas in general, or arrays in general, is array has different elements and different indexes, and if an element is an error, that most of Excel's functions will just skip that entire element's index and not even try to evaluate it. If it's not an error, then it'll try to evaluate it and it'll treat it like a normal value. For our case, though, we only want Excel to evaluate the lookup function if it equals our specific criteria of the level being 4. If it doesn't equal that criteria, we want Excel to completely skip it. So in our array that were zeros and ones, we want to keep the number ones as the number one, and we want to turn all of the zeros into an error so that Excel will skip it. Now, the easiest way of doing that is just putting that value of the array into the denominator of a fraction. And so if the value is false, you'll get a 1 over 0 or a divide by 0 error, which will be no match. And if the value is true, you'll get a 1 divided by 1, which the value has to be 1, and it is a match. So our array now becomes an error, 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 1, 1, 1, error. So now if we consider the actual lookup itself, based on the Microsoft page that we saw, if the lookup cannot find the lookup value, which is number 2, then it will return the largest value that is less than or equal to the lookup value from the lookup vector. So since Excel expects the lookup vector to be in ascending order, Excel will basically start from the bottom of the array or in our case, the right, and go backwards to the left, trying to find the highest number that it can that is less than or equal to the number 2. Now, like I said, Excel will skip the error. It will come over here. It will find the number 1. The number 1 is less than or equal to 2. And then it will go one more over. It will look at this value. It says, oh, that's the same thing as this one here, as the first one that I found. Well, I want to find the largest value that is less than or equal to 2. And I've already found that. So this next one, this one over here, I can just ignore it. I can stop my search, and I'll return the index over here of 6 that corresponds to this red number 1. So putting that into our actual table, it looks like this. In column D now, we have a div 0, div 0, div 0, 1, 1, 1, div 0. So as I was mentioning, it's either going from right to left or bottom to top. And as soon as it finds the criteria that matches the less than or equal to 2, it stops and it says, that's my number. So we get this 169-188-2200 for the parent of our level 5 here. And it does not return these erroneous 04 or 12 dash numbers. Now, if you use the VLOOKUP, you would get the erroneous 04 number instead of the way that we did it with a lookup value of getting this 169. Now, the very last aspect that I wanted to do is put this if error statement into the equation, because if I'm at the very top level, so I'm already at a level 1, there's not going to be a parent above a level 1. And in our formula itself, if it's already at a level 1, then this whole denominator here, instead of evaluating to a true or false array, will actually evaluate to 0 always, and we'll get a divide by 0, basically. So 1 divided by the 0 over here. This whole lookup function becomes an error statement, and now we get the dash over here for the top parent that we're dealing with. So in this video, I went over two new functions. One of it is the REPT, or repeat function, and another one is using the lookup to look for a specific value going from the bottom of a column to the top versus a traditional VLOOKUP, which would go from the top to the bottom. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Thank you.